Welcome, and we are here at the Indianapolis Circuit. It was Belt on an Oval, but today we are racing on the infield circuit, and Will Nutter, the defending winner, is going to start on pole. Can he continue his dominance here? But watch out, Jiří Mata is so close to him as well, in the McLaren as well, and Joseph Willows and Vinnie Sontag are not that far behind. And then we have the BMWs, the Williams, and that's it. The rest is like mixed up and all that. And then you have the Lazio, who's out qualified in car for his home race, and now we are here. Five red lights are here to signal start the race, and off we go. And Will Nutter has already has a head start, but look at this. Jiří Mata had an amazing start. And he's going to try to go around the outside of Will Nutter. Is it going to work? Yes, he has. Will Nutter has taken the lead of the American Grand Prix. Look at this. Andrew Nutter's made a brilliant start from 10th. Look at this. Evan Byrne with Caelan Bryce. And Evan Byrne's made has made a good start as well. And look at that. We have a battle going on here. That's Roque and Kuba. Roque side by side with Kuba. And Roque cuts him off as he takes 7th place. James Wood is having to go on his teammate as well. Adam Wolf overtaking Nicholas Mazia. So, yeah. Now, this is an overtake on Kuba now. George Rogue had the slipstream. You can see slipstream plays a huge role to the overtakes. So, yeah. Now, this is the start of Andrew Nutter. So, Andrew Nutter had pretty much of an okay getaway. He got past the Renault, then after under the braking he took the advantage and he's up to 6th place, almost having to go on the BMW. Now look at this is Roland Motian having to go on Alex Southgate. Then we have Dominic DeLazio overtaking Miklos Gal at the back as well, and this is a overtake, and Dominic DeLazio entertaining his home fans and up to braking. He takes 20th, and now Josh Rock having to go on Andrew Nutter, and Andrew Nutter's 6th place has unfortunately been short-lived though. So Andrew Nutter thinking about having to go now, and he had the slipstream back, but now is he going to take 6th place back? Yes, he does. And yeah, it was like half of the straight, you just get past. And then after the half the straight, you can get back the slipstream after the car behind, who's just jumped to the front. Look at this. This is Joseph Wallace having to go on Will Nutter. And the Ferraris are right behind the race pace right now. Look at this. This is Joseph Willows and Will Nutter side by side. And Joseph Willows manages to finish the move on the inside. Now this is James Willows having a lockup. And he has a Toyota of Page Knight behind. And look at this. Felix Sontag Lundberg having to go on Will Nutter. And this is disastrous for Will Nutter. He's lost the lead. And look at this. Josh Rogue having to go on Andrew Nutter. Now it's Jack Boyman's turn. Boyman and Andrew Nutter side by side. Who is going to stay ahead? And it's Boyman that jumps ahead now. And Caden Bryce team by having to go on Evan Byrne. And Evan Byrne's doing a good job in the Honda, really. And look at this, Felix Sontag making a move on his own teammate. They're side by side. Who is going to jump ahead down to turn one? And it's Felix Sontag. Now Kuba gonna have a go on Andrew Nutter. And side by side, and after Kuba finishes the move on the inside. So, yeah. Now look at this. Now the BMW is gonna have a go on Will Nutter. Oh my goodness! That is McKenzie who's gonna jump up to 4th place, and Will Nutter. Oh my goodness! What is going on for Will Nutter? Is he on a heavy fuel tank or is something wrong? I don't know. And Dominic Lazio thinking about having to go on Mazia. And now look at this. Caelan Bryce. Can he finally get past Evan Byrne? And Byrne defends. He's doing a good job fending off Caelan Bryce. Now Miguel Daniel having to go on Alex Southgate. And Southgate had to back off straight away. Bit of devastating. Look at this. Evan Byrne defending again. And can Caelan Bryce take 10th? Now he does side by side. Can Caelan Bryce finish the move coming down to turn 3? And yes, he does. Brilliant move from Kaden Bryce here. He's up to 10th now. Now, James Wood is thinking about having a move on him. He's fancying a look. But Evan Byrne defends. But that is brilliant battling going on here. Now, Adam Wolf having to go on Alex Southgate. And Southgate is becoming a sin duck in the world. Now, it's Delasio's turn to have a move going in. And he completes it. And now, Kaden Bryce thinking about having to go on Andronella. And look at this, down the inside, Andronella's gone off, he's gone wide, he missed his breaking point. He's thinking about aggressive defending, but it's not worked out. Now, Sin Cara's engine decided to have a barbecue here, and I want to tell you something. Sin Cara is speculating retirement, and yeah, he's speculating about leaving Spike at the end of the season, but I don't know if he's going to leave or not, but he was running in last place before his engine blew up, and there was his teammate overtaking Migrosi Daniel. Now Daniel's into the pits. He is our first person to come to the pits. He completes his pit stop. Now he rejoins in last, and look at this, Felix Sontag having a go on Joseph Willows, and it's Felix Sontag who jumps up to second place, and it's a revenge for Joseph Willis taking away Felix Sontag's win last time out. They're not even fighting for the win anyway. They were fighting for second place, but I don't really call that revenge. Now, Kaden Bryce finishes his pit stop. He's going to rejoin in 19th place. Dominic Delasio into the pit as well. So, yeah, he doesn't need to worry about two cars coming in at the same time. I don't think anyone needs to worry about that. So, yeah. So, now we have a battle going on here. And we are the top four are so close to each other now. I'm expecting to have a battle for the lead here. But McKenzie thinking about having to go on Joseph Wales. But no, he came into the pits. And it's a pretty much of a long pit stop for Jay McKenzie. 18 second pit stop for McKenzie. So I don't know where he's going to rejoin, but he's going to rejoin the midfield somewhere. Now Felix Sontag's into the pit as well. So yeah. So Felix Sontag thinking about he's thinking about a podium or something, I don't know, but Felix Sontag finishes his pit stop, and he's another one to do a slow one. So why are the pit stops a bit slow? Can Al-Safi do a quicker one? Or what about the Toro Rosso in front as well? I think that's Malaysia. Nope, an 18 second pit stop again. And yeah, you want to get a lot of fuel into the tank, because it's because of the long straight coming out to turn 11, and then once you go back, you finish the lap, then you go back down to, then you break to turn 1. It's about like 30 seconds of full throttle. I don't know how many seconds is that, but it's a long period of full throttle. Now Evan Byrne's done his pit stop, so Evan Byrne is going to rejoin 16. Oh yeah, that's Jack Boyman and Grace Cooper coming to the pits. Oh no, what happened in the Williams crew now? Now Cooper's race is going to be affected. Remember, last time out he took his best result. He finished in fourth, and now I don't think he's going to continue that point streak he's been having since Spain now. So Cooper is going to lose points, and now the mechanic's going to leave him stranded here. And this is just going back to worse for Cooper now. And Cooper rejoins in 20th place. Now, Cooper actually has a lot of work to do. And nope, to make it worse, Miklos Gal just jumped him. Now, Andronella finishes his pit stop. George Rogue is in the pits as well. Joseph Willows has finished his pit stop. He's done a quicker stop than anyone else. At least it's less than 18 seconds. Well, now George Rook's done a quicker one as well. So on board with Joseph Willows. Nope, here with Joseph Willows, and he just manages to jump ahead of Felix Sontag. Now Kuba having to go on Miklos Gal. Straightforward pass really, because Williams have a superior car than Toro Rosso really. Now here we are, we have Joseph Willows and And no one would replace the Irimata, sorry for the mistake there. But yeah, Irimata is comfortably leading the race. I don't know by how much, but he's into the pits now. And has he done his pit stop? I don't know. And the gap was about 6 seconds. Now Willem Nelle is into the pits as well. So who's gonna make the quicker pit stop now? And it's Irimata. Irimata's done to the 15.3 pit stop. Can't win another challenge that. He's gone under 15 seconds. But it won't change anything because the gap was huge. So nothing will change really. Now James Willows has taken the lead of the race. But oh, what is that Super Aguri doing? He's going to get lapped, but no, I'm actually not dreaming. Adam Wolf is running in third place, but he's yet to do a pit stop. And yeah, Alex Southgate's up to seventh as well. Now here we are with James Willows, the race leader, but it won't be for long because he has to come into the pits. Now Irimata, the original race leader, there we have Adam Wolf in third place. So is strategy gonna play a huge role to race results really? Well, I don't know, but he's causing a train with Willows and the Ferrari behind. I think that's Sontag. Now Adam Wolf's coming to the pits on lap 37. So is he gonna do a one stop? I don't know, but Joseph Wells thinking about having to go on Felix Sontag. Can he jump? And no, oh, Felix Sontag defends. And they were just an inch away from contact. But, you know, they are top drivers, so they know what they're doing, really. So, yeah, but be careful. There are other cars behind now. This is Dominic DeLazio making a move on Nicolas Daniel for 12th. And DeLazio is another one that's going to do a one-stop. I think that's about, like, all the backmarkers doing a one-stop. But Joseph Willows was fancying a lock on Felix Sontag. But Sontag's going to do a... But Sontag needs to defend. But he's going to try and squeeze him out into the pit. But can Joseph Willows? They're side by side now. And can Joseph Willows finish him up by the outside? But yes, he does. He's done it at turn three. Great move from Joseph Willows. And it's another overtake to add on this list now. And Will Nelle trying to have a look on George Roque or Jamie Kenzie. I don't know which one that is. And he's completed the move. And now Andrew Nelle having a side-by-side battle with James Willows. Look at that. Can Andrew Nelle defend? No, he can't. And then Andrew Nelle needs to be careful because he has DeLazio and Minxie Daniel behind. Now look at this. Andrew Nelle taking about having a move on James Willows and Dominic DeLazio overtakes Andrew Nelle around the outside, and I think Daniel's gonna get past Nelle as well. And look at that. DeLazio trying to make a move on James Willows, and Minxie Daniel is confirmed he's gone past Andrew Nelle. So Andrew Nelle has just lost two positions. Now this is a replay here. So Andrew Nelle just backed off because he had no space whatsoever. So James Willows just defended. He wasn't breaking any rules. Now Minxie Daniel just got past straight forward here because his top speed was faster than Andrew Nelle. His one got affected. Now DeLazio is into the pits, and what time is he going to do in the pits? And he's going to do a 12.6 pit stop, so he's putting less fuel in the cars. Caden Bryce is into the pits as well, and Roland Motian is going to stay out. So Caden Bryce is going to rejoin in 16th place. Now look at this, James Wells having a go with on page 9. And he's up to 8th now. He's taking the final point off Paige Knight. Now Caleb Bryce having him go on Adam Wolf. And Adam Wolf just misses breaking point. He went deep down to turn 1. And then it was just an easy pass for Caleb Bryce really. Now Daniel's into the pits. And I think that's going to be his final pit stop, I believe. He's done a 12.8 pit stop. Now Caden Bryce having to go on Andrew Nelle. And what is going on for Andrew Nell? Look, there's a side-by-side now. No, Zafri is Zafri. And he finishes the move at turn two around the outside. Now Adam Wolf telling about having to go now for Zafri as well. And that was so close to contact, really. The wing against the red tire, that wouldn't have ended badly. Now that's Kuba going around the outside of Mazia. And Kuba's pulling away significantly. Now he's pulled away about a second, really. Now Yuri Mata laps him. Now look at this, Daniel having to go on Dominic D'Alessio, and the Honda engine versus the Toyota engine. Whereas the Honda engine is pretty much quicker, really. Or is it? It's a tight slipstream now. Felix Sontag laps Miklos Gal, who locks up and Nicholas Mazzi into the pits, really. So he was slowing after Kuba overtook him around the outside. It's another case of a problem, because if it is, it is the second time he had to pit due to a problem. Second time in a row, really. Yep, it is like that. Now at Southgate, thinking about having a move on Azra Safri, side by side they go, and down the inside goes Southgate, and up to 15th place, and Safri is unfortunately being a sin duck. Now this is an onboard with no replay with Adam Wolf, and he locks up. It's pretty much the same thing that Joseph Willis did earlier on. Now George Rowe trying to make a move on his own teammate, the side by side, and coming down to the braking zone, and it's George Rowe that jumps ahead of Jay McKenzie. Up to fifth place he goes. Now look at this, Caleb Bryce and Roland Motian. Oh my goodness, Roland Motian go right. No, that he went on the grass just. And look at that, they are side by side. And look at that. Oh my goodness me, that is amazing stuff, amazing stuff. A beautiful race crowd, that's what I love to see, really. Now Will Neller trying to make a move on Felix Sontag. Now this is the bat. Now this is for the podium position. Can Will Neller take the podium of Felix Sontag? And yes, he does. He is up to third place now, the championship lead. And oh, and his brother Andrew Neller has spun. He's an eventful day so far. He's made a good start, then become a sin duck, then he made mistakes, and I thought he was going to recover that, really. Now he's out of the car, so he becomes our second retirement. So this is the replay with Andrew Nella, and he spun all by his own, and after the spin he still had his rear wheel spinning, so that one might not be his fault. So unfortunately for him, it's another case of retirement. And Caden Bryce repeats the brilliant move he did. And Roland Motian, respect to both of them for a brilliant battle. Now Caden Bryce having to go on Evan Byrne. And Caden Bryce is hungry to continue his point streak. Now Felix Sontag's into the pits for that's a quite late pit stop, really. He's done an 8.2 pit stop, so there are more cars coming into the pits. There's McKenzie, and there's Boyman as well, and there's a long pit crew coming out here. So what is going on? Did the teams miscalculate the fuel, or are we going to see some cars stop at the track on the final lap? I don't know, but I'm starting to get worried, really. Now Jack Boyens finishes pit stop, and look at this, Caden Bryce jumps, is back up to the points, really. He has 4 liters left, but can he save the fuel, really? He is in danger at the moment. Southgate's jumped ahead as well. Now look at this, both Toyotas came in at the same time. Roland Motian has been victimized. And now Evan Byrne stopped at the middle of the pit lane, and he still has the engine running. And oh no, Joseph Willis as well has been victimized. And well, that has taken the third place now. No, wait, I'm sorry. Wait, I got that wrong. So Joseph Willis finally does his pit stop. I don't know how long he stayed in there. And I don't know where he's going to rejoin, but he's going to rejoin outside the podium. Now Felix Sontag is going to take the podium off Joseph Willows, and Will Nett is not that far behind. So Joseph Williams is going to rejoin behind the BMWs. Oh, no. Now, McKenzie, can he get past McKenzie? There are about 3 laps to go. So, yeah, now here we are with Yuri Mata. He takes advantage on Will Nutter. Now he's leading the race comfortably. He doesn't need to worry because there are 3 laps to go. Now Adam Wilson did the pit, so is Alex Southgate. And now here we are on the final lap. We are here with a race leader, Yuri Mata. Like I was saying, Yuri Mata has taken advantage of a mischief from Will Nutter. Now, Yuri Mata, can he play something dangerous in the championship? Can he be a threat to Will Nutter and come around the final corner? And it's Yuri Mata that wins the American Grand Prix, and he sets the fastest lap on the final lap in the process. So, Will Nutter is going to finish in second place. So, Felix Sotter is going to finish in third. George Rowe will cross the line in fourth. And Jamie Kent will finish fifth, managing to hold off Joseph Williams and Caleb Bryce. Caleb Bryce has crashed on the final lap. And he was running in seventh place. His point streak is gone. And Mikkelsen Daniel as well has a problem. He's out on the final lap as well. And he was about to finish 10th. But he's going to finish in 11th instead. But he won't take the checkered flag that way. And Paige Knight is going to finish outside the points in 9th. So no points for her. And yeah, that's it really. So yeah, here we are with the race results. Yuri Mata wins the race from Will Nutter about 20 seconds than Joseph Willows finishing 6th. Sin Cara and Andrew Nella were the only retirements of the race. No penalties. And Yuri Mata, like I said, took the fastest lap. Andrew Nella's problem was caused by throttle failure. So the championship is heating up at the moment. So Yuri Mata and Will Nutter are separated by one single point.